edit and update and upload. So today we're doing a live show. We're talking about the supply chain. And it's almost like an oxymoron to call it a supply chain. Like, really? Supply and what? So supply and lots of headaches. I know it's a live show, but we're going to get into the guts and the glory of this thing right away, because my plan is to post this video right after we're done, and then everybody else can watch it. And we don't want them being bored with a live show and the typical drab that comes with it. So let's just jump into this. We did a video last week. We talked about what's going on with the supply chain. I asked you to comment. We got a lot of comments. Guys, like, thanks for the interaction. It's amazing. It turns out that when you hit the thumbs up button, like you should be doing right now, and help a brother out, and you comment on the videos, it has a massive impact on what YouTube does with it. And so we had some great exposure. We had comments from all over North America and the world about what's going on with the supply chain. And that is a great thing. So I appreciate the help. Let's continue to do that sort of thing, especially during this thread of information. I know when it comes to the supply chain, everybody, it's really easy nowadays, especially, right? Because is it a conspiracy or not? Like, seriously? We've all seen the videos, right? I did last week. I went and checked. Guys driving around the lumber yards, and they're just stacked right to the roof outside with lumber, skid after skid after skid, train load after train load. And so it got me into thinking. I did a lot of research, and I talked to some people in the industry, and I got some really good clarification as to what the heck is going on. And so I've got a visual aid I'm going to pull up. I know it's a little cheap and it's mousy, but listen, when you have a low budget operation like I do, you do what you got to do. And of course, as always, if you're interested and you've got a question, I'm going to do my presentation. And then what we're going to do is, if you have a couple quick questions afterwards, feel free, jump in there, super chat that sucker, and I'll get to it. But we're going to make this a short live stream tonight. I'm going to do another one really soon for members. We can help answer questions and that sort of thing, because that's what we do for our members. We help. But tonight, we're dealing with the issue at hand. So let's talk supply chain, and let's decipher between conspiracy. Is it the end of the world? Is it Armageddon? Or are we just trapped in like an alternate reality right now? Because here we go. What we're going to talk about here is this. This point on the graph that I threw up together is about 10 years ago. It's recent history, okay? It's after the collapse of the housing market, 2008. Back when nobody could get a job, a couple years later, we recovered. The red line represents the supply chain, and the green line represents the demand, okay? And you will notice that over the last 10 years, the demand is growing marginally faster than the supply, all right? If you remember, I did a video 4 years ago, and we did a subfloor system in a basement, and that represents the chain about here. Okay, thanks, Maddie. I'll just back that up. And so back then, we used to do OSB panels back at this point, $8 a sheet. Okay, it's currently at 60. But back when we did that video in the basement, it was around 10 to 12. And it was up. And it was creeping up slowly, because it's slowly the demand was going faster than the supply. All right? And what I want to understand is the supply chain is it's a picky thing. We've changed a lot of things in the last 30 years. We have just-in-time delivery, which means we're not warehousing anything anymore. Okay? The guys are going to go into the forest in Canada. They're going to cut down trees. They're going to stick it on a truck. They're going to ship it to Minnesota or somewhere else in the Midwest, and they're going to turn it into lumber, or they're going to send it over and cut it down on the West Coast, okay? And it goes straight to marketplace. There's no warehousing. So here's what happens. Our supply is not as growing as fast as our demand, all right? And there's a reason for that. And part of that growth is, if you're a company and you can make 100 units a day, and the demand is 105, you don't care about those other five people. You're not going to the bank, taking out a loan, doubling the size of your shop to make sure that you're making what they want, okay? You're in a nice, comfortable profit margin there. There's just enough demand. It's more than the supply. You get maximum dollar for your product. It's very profitable. And let's face it, we don't live in China, so guys that own these companies like to get paid. Nothing wrong with that. So up until just before COVID, we were experiencing a pretty deep gap in the supply chain, all right? And then we got the news of COVID and the supply fell off because people weren't even allowed to go to work. Don't forget the Canadian supply of the Americans, almost 50% of their lumber. Well, we got pretty aggressive with their attitude about what we're going to do during this thing. And the government paid everybody to stay home. So there was nobody cutting trees. There was nobody working. But during COVID, guess what happened? 50% of the population that still had a full-time employment that weren't directly affected by the stoppage, okay, the slowdown in the economy, all of those folks, what I call the government employees, all of those folks were still getting full salary. And now they had all this extra money they didn't know what to do with. I can't go on holidays. I can't travel, right? And I'm, well, honey, interest rates are low. The housing market is booming. Let's renovate and max out our dollar. Because we can take our vacation money, put it into renovations. Interest rates are almost zero, right? Everybody wants to buy my house. And the housing market took off at the same time as all this is going on. And the average Joe, like you and me, are stuck here going, wait a minute. What do you mean the price of OSB today is now $60? The average person can't afford that. Does that make any sense? And I'm going to share something else. This is going to be very interesting. La, 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 la. Let's do this. You need to understand that when there's only 10 pieces of something available, but the market wants 15, they just keep raising the price like at an auction, all right? Until they can sell those 10 pieces for maximum dollar. They're in business after all, and you can't get upset about a company wanting to make good dollars during a situation like this. Now listen, here's an income graph, okay? This is the median wage, median salary. Materials used to be available for building, construction, and renovation in and around this range. And the supply and demand curve hovered like this, no problem. Almost everybody could afford to do renovations that owned a house. People underneath this were renters, okay? But here, everybody could afford materials. Right now, the line is way the heck up here. The top, I would say 30%. If you're not in the top 30% of income earners, you shouldn't be buying things that are being affected by what's going on in the marketplace in the way of lumber, okay? But lumber's not the only thing that's a problem right now. So let's talk about the elephant in the room, because as soon as you get lumber prices going crazy, and we've all been around long enough to realize that there are seasons, prices go nuts. You know, we've had oil crisis in the 70s. We've had aluminum problems. We've had steel problems. There are a lot of factors going on that are affecting everything, okay? One of them is the cost. Here, I'm going to write this out, and I'll lift it up. The cost of shipping. At the same time that we have a shortage going on, shipping prices are going through the roof, okay? All of the ports in China are doubling and tripling the cost. You order something, you load a container as an importer, halfway across the ocean, you get a phone call, by the way, your shipping fees doubled while it was on the boat. This craziness is going on, all right? At the same time, you got the Suez Canal. Some moron decided to drive his boat through it sideways and plugged up all of the boats in the bloody right side of the planet from getting through to market. All right? He should be shot. That's just crazy. Like, the first time in history somebody got that drunk, they tried to take an ocean liner sideways through the canal? Really? Anyway, I mean, but seriously, Matt, come on. That's pretty stupid, right? All right. So we got shipping prices going through the roof. So all that cheap crap you like to buy on Amazon is starting to get expensive, right? Flooring is getting expensive because most of it comes from China. The Suez Canal has hurt everything else. Now there's no shipping containers left laying around because they're all in a boat stuck in the ocean. It's been one hell of a month. So let's go back. We've got a shipping problem. We've got the Suez Canal. And to top it all off, we had a force majeure. I don't even know how to spell it. We're going to just make it a mess so you can't tell. All right. Force majeure. It has an E on the end. I knew that part. All right. What's up? Fast and Furious. Suez Drift. Love it. Listen, the force majeure was Texas. And if anybody doesn't understand Texas, you got to understand petrochemicals. Okay. Now, That may sound pretty fancy to you, but what that means is plastic. All of a sudden, that means something, right? Texas got their butts frozen. It was a horrific storm. Had a hell of a winter. And in a part of the country where they're not used to winter, that's a big issue. So we're talking about all these manufacturing capacity, 40, 50% of resins, things that make OSB, not being made. Plastics, oil manufacturing, all that industry came to a screeching halt during the ice storm. A lot of their systems were compromised and frozen and blew up and had to be rebuilt. All right. And so on top of everything else, we've got a massive part of the commercial industry that had to be rebuilt and put back into production. Just last week, another major resin plant got back online. They're 3 months behind. So when everybody's out there looking at these videos of all the lumber stacked up going, why is it sitting there? Why is there a train of lumber not going? If you've ever built a house lately, you realize that you use a lot of stick lumber and a lot of sheet goods called OSB, floors, walls, roof. You can have all of the sticks of lumber you want, but if you don't have any OSB, you can't build a house. So what they do is they hold on to the sticks of lumber. They're not going to give you a deal in the meantime because there's only so much forestry going on. There's only so many trees getting cut down, and Canada's only shipping you X number of lumber. But in the midst of all of this, there's a housing boom. Like, could you do anything else? Maybe a good old-fashioned flood to wipe out the West Coast. I don't know. We are at the edge of extinction with our supply chain. And it's all because these people got so greedy and so full of themselves with their ability to do just-in-time delivery that now they can't even supply the marketplace. They are already confessing, you know what? Maybe we should take a look back at warehousing. Now, warehousing is going to increase the cost. $10 goes to 15 when you start warehousing. But 15 in my book, it's better than 60. Huh? Think about it. Now, the fact is Texas manufactures 40% of the resin. So we have a major problem. We're not getting ABS pipes, which means if you're building a new house, you don't have the sheet goods to build your house. You also don't have the plumbing to build the house. You don't have the plastics. There's new car manufacturing going on going, hey, we can't make our cars because we're kind of short on product. So you're not alone. Just realize, if you're frustrated with your supply chain this year, it's not that the government's against you, okay? It's not a conspiracy theory. There's not mean bad men running around ruling the world. It's just a fact of this. You want something that they can't give you, okay? And so they're going to sell it to the a number of people that they can supply at the highest price they're willing to pay. Now, if that means that you're out of the game this year, then don't feel sad. A lot of us are. It's expensive. We're expecting prices to start coming down in the second half of the year. It's not going to be something dramatic, like OSB is not going to go from $60 to $20 next week. It won't happen that way. I would be surprised if next year we aren't still looking at $30 a sheet for OSB. So be prepared. Thinking about doing a deck job, take a look at options. All of a sudden, building a composite deck starts to make a little bit of sense. It may be twice as expensive, but it's going to last 50 years and you're not going to have to touch it. I'm just saying, at the end of the day, we really got to be level-headed about this and understand that if the supply chain is out 5 or 10%, the prices go up a lot. But we've got like a 40, 50, 100% discrepancy in what's available, and they're just going to charge whatever they need to charge to keep the products on the shelf. And yes, we get all kinds of comments. Well, the stores are full and the prices are crazy. What's going on, Fred? Well, here's the deal. If a store sells 10 skids of product every week, they're going to continue to sell 10 skids of product every week because the supply chain is back to normal. Okay? But the demand is going to be 15 or 20. So the price is going to stay up because they can't get any more. When the store starts running out of drywall, you know we're in trouble. All right. And I got one more little demonstration here. I know I'm Captain Whiteboard tonight, but hey, this is really probably information that no one's talking about. You know, it's amazing that we've got an industry in the building world that is a $250 billion a year of home renovations. And you think the newscast would do anything about it? So before I give you any more information, I want you to hit the like button if you're watching. Make sure you add your comments. Complain. Scream. If you're a conspiracy theorist, I will welcome your comments. I'm not against it. If you feel betrayed by your government, feel free to say something, right? But just remember this. Here, we're going to just talk about how the companies work. This line is going to be their maximum capacity, the big black line. All right, ready? That's the maximum capacity. That's how much they can pump out if they work three shifts every day of the week and they never turn the lights off, okay? Right now, the demand for their product is like this. So they're at maximum capacity. They've hired everybody they can hire, all right? They've tired a pump cart to the dog to drag around the warehouse. They're done. They can't get any bigger. What are they going to do? Their next option, okay, is to go to the bank and say, give me money and bring me up to this level of production to satisfy the demand. Problem is, folks, in a few months, the demand is going to drop right back down to here again. And you're going to leave that guy running his business going, wow, that was a stupid idea to go into debt to build an expansion of my factory. Because by the time they're done the construction, the demand's going to drop off. So what they're doing is absolutely nothing. They're very content selling everything that they're making at top dollar. Well, the only thing that we have control over as the society is this, the demand. Bring it down. For the love of God, there are people out there who actually need a sheet of OSB to finish a bathroom renovation so they can sell their house. What I'm going to suggest is you watch the video we're going to do on Thursday. Okay? Thursday night, I'm releasing a video. We filmed it yesterday. I made a list of 10 renovations you can actually do this year. Things that aren't affected by the lumber price or the resin or the plastic problem. Okay? That give you great return on investment. Redivert your focus from what you think you want to something that can flatten that curve and make things more reasonable again, all right? End of the day, if you really want a deck this year, that means you didn't have one last year. And if you didn't have one last year, one more year ain't gonna kill you, all right? I suggest that you go one more year without that deck and you take your time and energy and you do something different with it. That way, next year, when we can get better prices on materials, you can build a deck and you're twice as far ahead. Don't just sit there and gripe about it. Make sure you're productive, okay? Watch the video on Thursday night and take the time to make lots of money. Remember, right now, housing markets are going boom all over North America, which means if you're smart as an investor, when every homeowner should be an investor, invest in yourselves. Make sure you're doing things that are increasing the value of your house, okay? Now, I know not everybody's going to watch this, so I'm going to give you some of the list. Paint, for the love of God. Paint is mostly water, okay? All right? We're surrounded by it. Trust me, we aren't having a shortage of water. If you paint the inside or the outside of your house, your average price of your value of your house goes up by 5%. If you're a researcher, check out the cost value report in the United States. And if you're in Canada, check out the United States cost value report. We don't have one up here, but you can find a city of similar size and similar demographics. It's not difficult to get an idea of how the housing market is affected, and you'll know what to do with your home, all right? Do things, windows, siding, anything outside the house, add mulch, aggregates. You know, in the midst of all of this, you can still get like almost free aggregates, right? It's $100 for a dump truck of stuff. It's in the way. They want to get rid of it. All you got to do is pay the guy to drive out and dump it. You can level out your property. You can fix your grass. You can build berms, put it in a cedar hedge. All these things are still available, okay? Add a patio, right? DIY a patio. Great idea. These products are available. You can do lots of tile work. You might not get the exact tile you want. Don't go to a store that says, oh, we're back ordered. It's coming from Italy. It'll be here next week. They're full of it, all right? Don't expect anything from Italy to ever show up next week. Italy is notorious for deciding at the drop of a hat that everybody on the dock is going to take a month off and just have a union break. So if it's not in the store, it's not available, right? Shopping rules number one. If it's not there now, it's not going to be there next week. Make plans based on what's in front of you that you can take home with you when you see it, all right? And go renovate something. Make your house beautiful. and make some money because this is a great year to renovate. All right. Now, I know we've all been in the comments. It's going crazy over here. I think it's awesome. Yeah, there's always something you can do. Anybody who thinks that just because they can't build a deck this year, the year's a write-off. Oh, it's just a waste of time. Oh, God, everybody's against me. No. Listen, you can build a patio. Do something small with paver stones, okay? You might not find the same style and the color that you're in love with, but it doesn't matter, okay? Just get something, build something. Increase the value of your home. All right, well, that's enough for me today. And if you like this kind of information, don't forget, give us a great big thumbs up, okay? And for all of the members out there, we're going to do another members video just for you guys real soon so we can do some Q&A. I'm not forgetting about you, but we're just in the middle of some major stuff right now. So we're going to schedule that and put in the community section real soon. I hope you guys are all doing all right. Stay safe. Enjoy your renovation year. It's going to be a little different. Kind of think more remodeling this year, okay? Don't go so major on your project, all right? And make everything beautiful in your home and enjoy it. Make your kids and your family proud of you and make your neighbors jealous. Cheers till next time. That's Jeff. We're gone. Bye-bye.